So it's awesome that everyone can join. Today, in today's training session, we're going to be looking at state of health check in a high voltage battery. The car we have here is an Audi A3, which is a plug-in hybrid. So when we first connect to the vehicle, I've got my screen being duplicated on here. Then we're going to either enter the registration number or enter the VIN number. On this car, we can enter the registration number, and this just gives us all of the vehicle details automatically. We can see we have an Audi A3. We even got the year and, more importantly, the engine code. So once we've done that, we can hit confirm. And then we kind of bring you to the landing or connection screen. Now, what does the technician want? He doesn't need to know which computer to go to or anything else. What he really needs to know is, I want to carry out a state of health check, and the software will automatically detect which ECU we need to go to and what we need to do. So to do this, I'm going to use the new quick find feature, which is this little search icon here. When I first click it, I'm going to get all the list of everything that can be done on this car. As you can see, it's pretty extensive. And in this search box, because we've got such a big list, we need to narrow it down. We're going to do the state of health. And we have one option available here. This is in the electric vehicle section from the icon, and we can see we've got battery state of health. When I click this, you'll see on the right-hand side, we now have a full file which guides us through on what to do. More importantly, we need the ignition on, engine not running, because this is a plug-in hybrid. The high voltage system must be active, and we're good to go. So let's click the start menu. What's going to happen now is that the tablet is going to connect to the VCI. The VCI is the part that we plug into the car. Automatically on Bluetooth. Very quick check. We've put this up here with the battery voltage is at 13 volts. Okay. If we're seeing the battery voltage drop down, we definitely need a battery support unit on there. So from the drop down menu, we've connected to the right system. Let's head into battery state of health. Same help file is there. Let's click on the play button and let's start the procedure. Now it's important to note that this, what we're running here, this protocol already exists in the battery, and the Delphi software is just accessing it. We are triggering the routine to run, and essentially we run the routine and the battery reports back to the Delphi tool on all of the values. Let's have a quick look through them. We have all of the cells of the battery here. So we essentially have three columns, all of the battery cells. We then move across, we have all of the actual values from the car, and they either be green or red, whether they're in or out of specification. And then the last column we have here is the tolerance. So as long as it's between these two numbers, we know that the cell is good. If we scroll through the cells all the way down, we can see when we get to the final, to the bottom, there are a lot of battery cells in this. We end up with 96 cells down here at the bottom. So the Delphi tool will use the routine, check all 96 cells and give us the report. At the end, we can press OK. And then more importantly, we're going to want to keep a copy of this or give it to the customer. We've always got the save button or the print button here to be able to save that, email it to the customer as a PDF. And this just gives that customer that peace of mind that their vehicle, and it may be a very new vehicle, the car we're working on now has actually done just over 200,000 kilometers, and we've still got a good healthy battery. So it's important that it gives that customer that level of confidence when they're purchasing or deciding whether to keep the car, that the battery is, it is safe. So back to the beginning then, we can run any routine that we like. All we have to do is type it in here and trigger the routine from there. So appreciate your time today. Thank you for watching. Any questions, then pop up and see me and enjoy the rest of your day.